I'm gonna give me a little snack. Miss, give me about 3 hamburgers.
3? How would you like them cooked?
I want them raw.
Honest?
Well, that's the only way to eat them is raw. With a thick slice of onion and some pickle in.
Well, if you're sure you're not joking.
No. Hold on, miss. That ain't all. I also want me some ham and eggs and some potato salad and a piece of pie. I ain't too particular what kind of pie it is, as long as it's got that meringue on top of it.
Well, we got lemon and chocolate, but they both got meringue.
Lemon and chocolate. Well, I like them both. I don't know which one I'd rather have. I'll take them both.
Both?
Yep. Instead of pouring the milk down beside me, I'm still a growing boy. Traveling always picks up my appetite. Was that all you're going to eat, just a measly donut?
I ain't hungry.
Well, why not?
I just don't.
Well, you ought to be.
Well, I ain't.
Huh. Well, you just wait till I get you up to Susie Q. Couple of weeks, I'll fatten you up. Oh, but I love you just the way you are, Cherry. You got the cutest little piece I ever seen. Man, when I come in that nightclub place, I heard you singing my favorite song, standing there in front of the orchestra looking like an angel. Well, I told myself in there, she's for me, and I ain't leaving without her. Now I got you, ain't I, Cherry?
Oh, there's people here, and they're looking.
So what if they aren't looking? It's no crime to show a little affection, is it? Especially when we're going to get married. It's no crime I ever heard of.
Well, for crying out loud, just let me be.
That's no way to treat your husband.
That is all you've done since we left Kansas City is maul me.
Oh, well, is that so? Well, I ain't one to pester no woman with my affection. I ain't never had to beg no woman make love to me, did I, Burge?
No.
I ain't never had to coach no woman make love to me, did I?
No,
but now, everywhere I go, I got all the women I want. I gotta fight just to keep them off of me, don't I, Burge?
Well, here's your hamburgers. Ham and eggs will take a few minutes.
All right, so give me a start.
Now, honey, I have got the darndest headache.
Oh, I'm sorry, Grace.
You think you can look after things for a while?
Oh, sure.
Because the only thing for me to do is to go upstairs and lie down for a while. That's the only thing that'll do me any good at all.
What's the matter, Grace?
Well, I've got this headache, Will. It's driving me wild.
Well, is that so?
You are now mistress of the inn.
Well, you never told me about your first wife.
Now, how could I have omitted her? Now, she was the most beautiful of any of them. I do believe she was. They had a most idyllic honeymoon together. A golden month, sunshine, romance in Bermuda. She later sued me on the grounds of mental cruelty and persuaded the judge that she should have my house, my motor car, and an alimony that I still find it difficult to pay. But she chose never to marry again. As she found out for what she wanted out of marriage, she didn't have to marry. And that's a being unkind.
Mia, would you wait for me, a lady maid?
Oh, I'm sorry. It's ready right now.
All right.
There you go.
And them hamburgers was just a horse to Uvry. Thank you. Got that gone? Cherry, what'd you bring your suitcase in here for? Tell me. No, I'm asking you a simple question. Tell me.
Now, please don't come near me, Mo.
What's your suitcase doing behind the counter? You trying to fool me? That was in her plan to do? You plan on getting rid of me?
Just take your hands off of me, Bodega!
Tell me, Cherry! Tell me! Let go of her! Mister, you ain't got no right to interfere between me and my fiancée.
Well, maybe she's your fiancée, and maybe she is. Anyway, you're not going to abuse her while I'm here. Understand?
Abuse her?
Yes, you better tell him just how you feel about things.
Well, I...
What's this critter trying to say, Cherry?
You better tell him, miss.
Well, I... Don't get mad.
I'll get mad if I feel like it. What you two got planned?
I don't want to go up to Montana and marry you.
You do too?
I do not.
Anyways, you'll come to like it. I promised you would. Now, we've been through all this before.
But, Bo, I ain't going.
What?
I ain't going. The sheriff said he's going to help me, and he's not going to let you take me any farther. I'm staying here and taking the next bus back to Kansas City.
You ain't going to do nothing of the kind.
Yes, I am, Bo. You got to believe me. I ain't going with you in this bottle.
The Cherry. We was... familiar with each other.
Well, that don't mean you have to marry me.
Ooh, I gotta put you across my knee and blister your little bottom.
Don't you touch me.
Mister, you can't pay no attention to what she says. Women folk don't know their own minds. Never did.
Don't you come near me.
You are gonna follow me back up to Timber Hill and marry up. You just don't think you like it now because you've never been there. The whole thing's kind of strange. But you'll get over them feelings. In no time at all, you'll be happy as a mud hen. Now, I ain't taking no for an answer. By God, you're coming alone.
You can't take her on that bus with you if she don't want to go. Can't you get that through your skull, cowboy?
This
now, leave her be.
This ain't no business of yours.
It's my business when a little lady comes to me wanting protection.
Is that right, Cherry? You go to Sheriff asking for protection?
Well, I guess I did.
Well, what you need protection for? A man who wants to marry you?
Cause
what? I said I love you, didn't I?
I know you did.
See there? I told her I love her and I want to marry her. Now, the world full of crazy people out there going around killing each other. You ain't got nothing better to do than stand here trying to keep me from it?
You're overlooking just one little thing, cowboy.
Well, you're so smart. Tell me, what am I overlooking?
You're looking over a small but important fact. That little lady don't love you.
Okay, take it easy, Bo. Come on, don't blow your up. He's the sheriff. Hold your temper, dear. Come on.
That pokehead bastard!
Pay me.
You said she don't love me.
Pay no attention. Would you sit down? You gotta think things over.
Let me be, Marge.
If you don't believe me, ask her. Ask the little lady if she loves you.
I won't ask her none of the kind.
Well, then you take my word for it.
I wouldn't take your word for a cloudy day. She loves me and I ought to know.
Well, she ain't getting back on that bus with you. And that's the last thing I've got to say about that. And you better sit down with your friend there and have a quiet game of pinochle until that bus gets on its way with you on it.
If you like he says, Bo. I think maybe he got the little lady all wrong, man.
Don't you say nothing against her, Bird.
I ain't saying nothing against her. I just see no reason why you should marry a gal that says she don't love you, that's all. I kind of doubt she's as good a gal as I think she is. Now come over here and sit down.
I don't feel like sitting.
I don't think it'll be bothering you more tonight, ma'am. If you are, my office is just across this road there. You can holler.
Thank you very much, I'm sure.
Alma? You gonna be all right?
Yes, Will.
And I'll look in a little later.
All right, thanks, Will.
I don't know why it is, but I always seem to relax more easily when the sheriff leaves the room.
I don't know why people hate Will so much just because he's the sheriff.
My dear. He stands as a symbol of authority, one of the most dreaded figures of our time. Oh, policemen, teachers, lawyers, judges, doctors, and even, I suppose, tax collectors. Why, we take it for granted that the punish us with something that we didn't do, or did do.
Yeah, but you were a teacher once.
But not a very successful one. I could never stay in one position for very long a time. I hated having people over me, like deans and presidents and department heads. I was never the type of man who could take orders from anyone without feeling resentment. Right or wrong, I have always insisted and I have it my own way.
What am I gonna do, Virg?
Don't you just gotta quit depending on me? I don't know what to tell you to do except to sit down and be peaceful.
I can't be peaceful.
Alright then. Pace around like a panther and be miserable.
I just can't believe it.
What can't you believe? Oh, nothing. You got something on your chest, though, it's best to get it off.
Virg. I just never realized that a gal might not love me.
Well, where else did you teach?
Well, my last position was at one of those revolting progressive colleges in the East where they offer curriculum that they call functional education. Now, educators, I'm sure, despaired of ever teaching their students anything. So they decided that the next best thing would be to understand them. Every day we would have a meeting of everyone on the entire faculty with whom the students might come into contact. From the president down to the chambermaid. Then we put our heads together and try to figure out why, like little Jane or little Mary, wasn't getting out of her classes what she should. The suggestion that she wasn't studying was too simple. That she brains for a college education, like being under a crap.
Well, I bet you disapproved of that college.
My dear, I have disapproved of my entire life.
Really?
Yes. I suppose I could resist living it all over again.
Did you resign from that teaching position?
One day I decided I'd had enough. I walked into the dean's office blithely and said, "Sir, I graduated magna cum laude from the University of Chicago. I attended Oxford on a Sproul scholarship and returned to take my PhD at Harvard, receiving it with the highest honors. I believe that I have the right to expect my students to understand me."
Well, what did he say?
I feel responsible. Right out of the office, went to the railroad station, got a ticket to the farthest place I could think of. Had to be Las Vegas. And I have been traveling ever since. On a merry way to go to party.
Well, I thought I might teach one day, but you don't make it sound very attractive.
Oh, suit yourself. Look at me, suit you one way or another, but you're just such a lovely young lady.
Oh, thank you, Dr. Lyman.
Did you tell me that you planned to go to Topeka tomorrow?
Oh, you mean today? Yes, I have a ticket to go see the symphony.
You stay with your sister while you're there?
Yes, and then I take the early morning bus back here on Monday for school, and, well, then I'm back to work at Grace's at night.
Did you tell me that there was a university in Topeka?
Washburn University.
Washburn University, of course. You know, it just occurs to me that I should stop off there and check some references on a piece of research I'm engaged on.
Oh, I've been to Washburn Library lots of times.
You have? Well, maybe you could take me there.
Oh, I mean...
Oh, well, I'll get to Topeka before you, but then I'll meet your bus at the depot and we can go off in that. Well, you can take me to the library, and then perhaps we can have dinner afterwards. Then perhaps you'll permit me to take you to the symphony.
Are you serious?
Of course I'm serious. Why do you ask?
Well, it's just that older folks don't usually take notice of kids like me.
Oh, it's all right. I will. I am. Then I may depend upon it that I have an engagement.
Oh, of course. Yes, I'm very excited.
Well,
let's not tell anyone, okay?
Well, why not?
Well, you see, I have married, and, well, I am somewhat older than you, though perhaps not quite as much as you might take me to be. Oh, anyway, people might not understand.
Oh, well, if you think it's best.
I do think it's best. Certainly, let's keep our plans to ourselves. Promise?
Okay. That was real pretty, Virgil.
Thank you, miss.
Isn't there some other way of getting me back to Kansas City? I'm sorry. As long as the road's blocked, that's the only way to get back to Kansas City. I mean, I can't get anywhere either. Well, I was just getting sort of restless.
What's up for me like a good girl, Whip?
Oh, sure, Whip.
Yeah, I'm going down the highway a bit to see how men are getting on. I thought they might like a hot cup of coffee.
Oh, what a good idea.
Grace been down yet?
No.
Well, I didn't see Carl anywhere outside. Do you think something could have happened to him?
I don't think you have to worry about him, Will.
Yeah, well, you're probably right. I think Carl can handle himself all right. Is everybody behaving?
Yes, Will. I'm just having so trouble with that. There you go.
All righty. Thank you, Emma.
Thanks, Will.
And if anybody comes looking for me, I won't be gone very long.
All right.
Thanks, Sheriff. If it wasn't for him, I'd get Sherry.
Where would you take it, Bo?
There's a justice of the peace down the street. You see a sign from the window.
Well, you can't force a gal to marry you. You just can't do it. The sheriff's a stern man, he'd shoot you in a minute if you thought it was his duty. Why don't you go over there to the county and have yourself a drink, like the professor?
I never did drink. I ain't gonna let no gal drive me to it.
You don't drink, you don't smoke or chew. You gotta have some bad habits to rely on when things with women go wrong.
Virge, I hate to sound like a pitiful weakling of a man, but it's been so lonesome these past few months, I don't know what to do with myself.
It's no disgrace to feel that way, Bob.
You ever get lonesome too, Virge?
A long time ago, I gave up romancing and decided I'd just take being lonesome for granted.
I wish I could do that. I can't.
Maybe I'm sad. Why do you say that?
Well, I just don't know why I don't go off to Montana and marry him. You know, I might be a lot better off than I am now.
Well, he says he loves you.
He don't know what love is.
What makes you say that?
All he wants is a girl that he can throw his arms around and hug and kiss. That's all. The rest of the time, he don't even know I exist.
Well, why'd you tell me you're going to marry him?
You ain't very experienced, are you?
No, I guess not.
I never did tell him I was going to marry him. You know, everything was going just fine until he brought up that subject. You know, Bo come in one night when I was singing that old Black Magic. It's one of my best numbers. And he liked it so much, he jumped up on a chair and yelled like an Indian. Then put his fingers in his mouth and whistled like a steam engine. Well, naturally, it made me feel good. Most of the other customers at the Blue Dragon was too drunk to pay any attention to my songs.
And you liked him?
Well, I did think he was awful cute.
I think he looks a little bit like Burt Lancaster, don't you?
Well, maybe. Well, anyway, I just never seen a cowboy before. I've seen him in the movies, of course, but never one in the flesh. And he's just so darn healthy looking. I don't mind admitting, I was attracted right from the start.
You were?
Yeah, but it was only what you might call a, sexual attraction.
Oh.
Well, the very next morning, he wakes up and hollers, "Yippee, we're getting married!" I honestly thought he was crazy, but when I tried to reason with him, he wouldn't listen to a word. He stayed by my side all day long like a shadow. Well, at night, of course, he had to go back to the rodeo, but then he was back to the Blue Dragon just in time for the midnight show. You know, if any other fella claimed to have a date with me, Bo would beat him up.
So you never did tell him you'd marry him?
No!
He kept telling me all week that he and Virgin would be by the night the rodeo ended and they'd pick me up and we'd all start back to Montana together. Well, I knew that if I was around the Blue Dragon that night, that's exactly what had happened. So I decided to beat it. You know, one of the other girls at the Blue Dragon, she lives on a farm across the river in Kansas, and she said I could stay with her. So I went to the Blue Dragon last night, but I just sang for the first show. Then I told him I was quitting. I'd been wanting to find another job anyway. And I picked up my share of the kitty. But darn it, I had to go and tell him I was taking the midnight bus. They had to go and tell Bo, of course, when he come in a little after 11. You know, he paid them $5 to find out. Well, anyway, I headed down to the bus station and hadn't even gotten my ticket yet when here come Bo and Birch. Then he just steps right up to the counter and says, "Three tickets to Montana." Well, I didn't even know what to say. Then he picked me up, dragged me onto the bus, and I've been on it ever since. You know, somewhere deep down inside of me, I got a funny feeling I'm going to end up in Montana.
Let me ask you something, Virg. We've been together since my folks died, and I always wondered if I didn't spoil your chances of settling down.
No, Bo, you never. I used to tell myself you did.
Well, we've been together since I was 10.
I could have married up too.
Well, was you ever in love?
Almost. Before I went to work on your daddy's ranch.
What happened?
Nothing.
Would you ask her to marry you?
Nope.
Why not?
Well, there comes a time when every fellow's life, but he's got to give up his own ways.
How do you mean?
Well, I was always uncomfortable around this gal. Right? She was sweet and kind of fine. I was always scared I'd say or do something wrong.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
I was kind of cowardly, I suppose. Every time I'd come back to Porter and get back to the bunkhouse, my buddies were sitting around talking, playing cards, listening to music. I just relax and feel so much at home, I didn't want to give it up.
Yeah. Gal sure can't scare a fella.
Now I'm kind of ashamed.
Y'all?
Yes, I am. Fella can't live his whole life depending on buddies.
Why don't you like me, Virge?
Well,
no, tell me the truth.
Well, maybe you don't go about it right.
Well, what'd I do wrong?
Sometimes you sound a little bullheaded. Mean.
I do?
Yeah.
Well, how's your fella supposed to act?
Yeah. Well, according to Bo, it seems to me you should act a little more gallant.
Gallant?
Yeah.
Gallant. Well, I'm as gallant as I know how to be. Well, you hear the way Hank and Orville talk when they get back from in town soldiering about the women.
They like to brag, bro. Can't believe everything Hank and Orville say.
Well, I mean, a gal ought to go for me soon as she would Hank or Orville.
They're older than you. They want a little more. They can be gallant gals when they want to be.
Well, I ain't gonna pretend.
Well, I can't blame you.
What? A gal ought to like me. I can read, I can write. You know, I'm kind of tidy, and I got good manners, don't I?
Well, I'm no judge, Bill. I'm used to you.
Well, and I'm tall and strong. Ain't that what gals like?
Yeah.
And if I say so myself, I'm pretty good looking.
I know you are, Bo.
Well, I get all spruced up. I'm as good looking a fella as a gal might hope to see.
Of course you are.
What in hell? Fire and damnation. Why won't she go back to the ranch with me?
Gee, if you only loved him.
Yeah, that'd solve everything, wouldn't it? But I don't. So I just can't see myself going up to some godforsaken ranch in Montana where I'd never see no one but him and a lot of cows.
Yeah, if you didn't love him, it'd be awfully lonely.
You know, I don't know why I keep on expecting myself to fall in love with someone, but I do.
Well, I know that's what I expect.
I'm beginning to wonder if there even is the kind of love I have in mind.
Well, what's that?
I don't know. I mean, I'm only 19, but you know, I've been going with guys since I was 14.
Honest?
Honey, I almost married a cousin of mine when I was 14, but Pappy wouldn't have it.
Why I never heard of anyone married so young.
Well, down in the Ozarks, we don't waste much time. But you know, I'm awful glad I never married my cousin Malcolm, because he turned out real bad, just like Pappy predicted. But I sure was crazy about him at the time. And I've been losing my head about some guy ever since. But you know, Bo was the first one that ever wanted to marry me, besides cousin Malcolm. And you know, naturally, I want to raise a family and get married and all of them things, but I just...
But you've never been in love.
Yeah, maybe I have and didn't know it. You know, maybe I don't know what love is. Maybe it's something that I'm not even expecting it to be. I don't know. I just feel that, well, regardless of how crazy you are about some guy, you just gotta feel that, I don't know, it's hard to put into words. You just gotta feel that he respects you. Yeah, that's what I mean.
Well, I should think so.
I mean, I want a guy that I can look up to and respect. But I don't want one that's gonna browbeat me. And I want a guy that can be real sweet. I don't want to be treated like a baby either. I don't know. I just feel that, like, well, whoever I end up marrying, they gotta have some real regard for me. You know, apart from all the loving and the sex, you know what I mean?
Yes. But what are you gonna do once you get back to Kansas City?
I don't know. Well, there's a hillbilly program on one of them radio stations there. Maybe I'll get a job on it. If I don't, I'm sure I'll end up going back and working at Liggett's or Walgreens, and then after a while, I'll probably end up marrying some guy whether I think I love him or I don't. I mean, who am I to just keep on insisting I fall in love? You know, you hear all about love when you're a kid, and you just take it for granted that such a thing actually exists. Maybe you have to find out for yourself that it don't. Maybe. Everybody's afraid to tell.
Maybe you're right, but I sure hope not.
Gee, I really don't want to go out to that cold powder room, but I guess I better not put it off any longer.
How defiantly we pursue love as if it were an inheritance due that we had to wrangle about with angry relatives to get our fair share.
Well, you shouldn't complain. You had three wives.
Oh, don't shame me. I loved them all. Passion. Well, I thought I did for a while.
I'm so sorry, Dr. Lyman. I didn't mean to sound sarcastic.
I don't apologize. I'm too egotistical to ever take offense at anything people say.
Oh, no. You're not egotistical at all.
Oh, the greatest egos are those that are too egotistical to show you how egotistical they are.
I guess I'm just sort of an idealist. I mean, I always thought that when two people really fell in love, it'd be forever and ever.
Maybe we have lost the ability. Maybe man has passed that stage of his evolution wherein love is possible. Maybe life will continue to become so terrifyingly complex that man's anxiety about his mere survival will render him too parsimonious to give of himself in any true relationship.
Why, you're talking over my head.
But true people really in love must give up something of themselves.
Yes.